Hey, what's going on, guys? Miss Merrick's back with some ARMA 3 win campaign episode live streaming. I finished last mission, or last evening. I ended the mission last night. Because of frustration after 3 hours of streaming, I kind of got stuck in that one particular mission where for some reason it wouldn't end, even though I thought I actually had the task completed multiple times. I'm not going to continue there because I have replayed the entire mission previously to the stream. I've replayed that. I took a slightly different approach, and that time kind of the trigger fired or whatever happened and the mission was successfully ended. But you have not actually missed anything when I continue now. So what I will do is continue with the next mission, the follow-up mission on the stream from last night. As you can see here on the tactical map of Altis, Blue Force in control of almost the entire map. CSAT sort of have retreated to whatever island they are on and kind of standing by. I'm currently fighting AAF, so like the Altis armored forces, and we're currently pushing them here up north or northeastern in that part of the island, and then the same thing goes for the southeastern side, and then that's that. But the mission, or basically the campaign, probably will not be done by then. I expect CSAT to sort of come back with a major attack and whoop NATO's asses. But mission at hand is taking the solar station here, and then pushing further northeast into Kalotrori. I am starting in a Blackhawk, in a Ghost Hawk down here. Also, I will be inserted by a helicopter probably to that LZ, and then I have to push into that compound, secure it from there, probably regroup with other elements and push into the city. Now, what I just found out, I'm not sure if it is on all the missions now or if it's because I start this particular mission inside a helicopter, is when you go to the team tab here in the briefing, and then on your name you have an inventory button here which gives you like sort of like an ammo box, if you will, but yeah, a variety of weapons, so you can prepare your loadout here, and I guess the mission will start you with that loadout. You can do the same thing for your AI buddies, so the guys in your team can mark one of those and change his loadout as well. I know it was possible in previous games, like in ARMA 2 or so, with some mission scripting, you could actually enable that feature. Now in ARMA 3, it's the first time it caught my eye. I'm not sure if it's always there, sort of, or just for that particular mission, but anyways, it is here. So I'm gonna maybe do some slight adjustments. I think I'm gonna grab some AT, you never know. And what kind of scope do you have? I have no idea what time it is. Or do I? 7:45. Well, morning or evening? That's kind of the question. I think I'm gonna bring me a night vision scope in the inventory. How many mags do we got? Only 5 magazines. I don't need that crap. I got a suppressor for the pistol already, so I'm gonna grab me some more magazines. More frag grenades, more smoke grenades, more UGL grenades. And then, no clue if I'm gonna be tasked to blow something up. I have one demo charge, I guess that should do the job. Alright, I got an ACOG, night vision scope, some extra rounds, smoke, frags. Where did the night vision scope go? We need binos? No. Okay, it's here now. Alright, let's do this. And we'll see in game when the mission starts if it actually worked with that loadout manager. get the PCML missiles. I think they should be in the launcher, shouldn't they? With the TMR mod? It's disposable, or?
Get set for landing. 60 seconds.
Actually, if I remember correctly, I had the same issue yesterday. I think you're right, I was supposed to bring a freaking missile. Even though it's a disposable launcher. Damn it. Airborne.
Eagle. Enemy anti-air gun neutralized. Over.
Copy that, Eagle. RTB. Golf 2-1, you're clear for landing. LZ is hot. Nomad, get boots on the ground. Push towards the solar station. Secure that position. Over.
Copy that, Crossroads. Out.
That's a pretty nice tactical inspiration. Get the Ghost Hog flying in, same time. Warthogs taking out AA defenses, and then the sideways approach of the Ghost Hog to the gunners are actually able to engage them. See if that launcher works. Fuck. You red Hawkeye? Okay, my bad. At me, but
hostile down.
The hell was that?
Team Green, move 100 meters front.
Copy. Running low on ammo. I got him. Soldier, 200 meters, right up ahead.
This place seems to be pretty clear already. My buddies are, I don't know where they're going.
They're not really saying where we're going. 200 meters, front!
Team Red, return to formation.
Copy!
I guess the first solar plant is pretty much clear already. I'm gonna try to get some high ground. Going on.
Team Green, move 200 meters right.
Copy that.
Okay, there's
man. 200 meters right.
So far, not as intense as some old mission last night. Not as much bullets coming my way. Not necessarily a bad thing, because otherwise it would just be complaining about dying all the time. Okay, friendly NPC. If there's some gear in there, so maybe I can find me a rocket
man,
or a missile to that launcher.
Target down.
Advancing.
18 soldiers, 75 meters, front. Machine gunner, 75 meters, front. Flag one.
About the gap here.
Oh, target neutralized.
For once, my eye buddies do a pretty good job. Nearby friendlies.
All teams, be advised. Confirm your targets. You've got friendlies operating in your AO. Out.
Where's my team? Coming. Seems to be a hostile there.
Team Green, engage that man just up ahead.
Copy, I'm on it. Engaging.
Engaging.
Move it.
Contact. Machine gunner. Scratch one. Target down.
This guy even takes his pistol out. Where's that grenadier?
Cover, go! Move out!
Team Red, move 75 meters front!
Roger!
What's that guy? Relax, guys.
Running low on ammo.
I got him.
Standing by.
Crossroads. Gamma is secure. How copy? Over.
Copy that.
And it's done.
Nomad, Charlie 2-3, dig in at Gamma. Set up a defensive perimeter. Hold that position. Delta 3-4, Nomad, rally up and get set to push northeast. Yeah. Out.
Alright. Got some AT now. And second missile. Might as well drop that one.
Be advised, support units are now on standby. Out.
8 max. Apparently got artillery. What now? Do I have to dig in or. Ah, I have to move. Let's drive then.
Board that vehicle.
Roger.
Standing by.
Stay sharp.
Standing by. Standing by.
Standing by. Waiting.
You guys coming?
Waiting. Ready.
With the bricks. Using a GPS is always good if you got one. Just figured out yesterday that you can actually resize it, resize the window of that in the game settings somewhere. In the screen layout. So also where you can place all the in-game HUD information. You can replace that into other areas of your screen if you want. Or some of them can be resized, just like the GPS or also the brand new the drone view. It's something that came new with this update. Whenever you connect it to a drone via UAV terminal, you can customize a hotkey in the key configuration, and then you will be able to open a pop-up image basically of the drone. So that's pretty neat. And that can also be resized, so mine is a bit bigger now than in default. And if you want, you can have it on the right, on the left, whatever you feel comfortable with.
Dismount.
Copy. Ready.
Waiting. Standing by.
Standing by.
Ready.
Alright, so we're here now.
Standing by. Standing by.
It says regroup with friendly forces. And then attack.
Team Green, move left.
Copy.
Team Red, move right.
On the way.
Or do I have to dig in here?
Standing by.
What's happening?
Waiting.
Crossroads, interrogative. We got a drone at our disposal? Over.
Affirmative, Nomad. Put it to good use. Remember, combining artillery with the UAV will give you the upper hand in this operation. Do not waste this opportunity. Out.
Okay, I got a drone. apparently.
Nomad, be advised. Enemy marksmen were neutralized at the solar complex. If you're in a pinch, their weapons may come in useful. It's imperative we sustain the momentum. Out.
Okay, well, the marksmen's are back where I came from. But I don't have a UAV. Oh, I do have a UAV terminal. Alright. Good to know. Oh, hey, now I can just show you that. So that's the UAV footage. Doesn't help you much right now. Let's see if I can just aim it at the target. Alright, let's scan that town. That looks like a Gorgon APC. But it's disabled. And this is kind of a hardened position, like a small camp of some sorts. Quite a bit of infantry movement. Very much so. Over there. That's a wreck. That's not gonna be a threat to me, and I guess that's over there is where I am at. Still don't get the drone stabilization right. That's where I'm at, that compound over there with the truck on the road. So I'm guessing we got about 10 to 15 infantry. But vehicle wise, it's not really a threat. But this is sort of like, from my point of view, when I look into the city, okay, that's exactly where the marker's at. So attack. Don't think I have to wait for anything now, so I'm just gonna call in artillery right in that spot. It's probably gonna be most effective. Scorcher. I don't have any vehicles, so laser guiding from the UAV or so is not going to be necessary. I'll just call in HE rounds.
Requesting immediate fire support at the designated coordinates. Over.
I don't know how much I get available, though. But
coordinates is inbound. Out.
So let's try that again. I'm just going to try to have the drone focus on that area. Then I release the controls, and now with the hotkey I've set up, it should sort of give me that image there, but apparently it doesn't really do that. I see the drone flying around, but yeah, that's about it, so that doesn't help me much. Alright, rounds are underway. How far out am I?
Splash out.
It's about 400 meters.
Fall back.
Solid copy.
Alright, let's go. Chill out here. We'll have the have my buddies regroup with me. Let's see what damage I've done. Oh, a lot apparently. I think I didn't get a single kill there. Well, maybe one or so. Aligning. taking control of the flying the drone doesn't help a lot either, because there's not really any threats there. I still have artillery available. I could try with the no one of mines, that's gonna be nasty when I have to get in there. The mine cluster, but cluster shell, so DPICM.
Requesting immediate fire support at the designated coordinates. Over.
Target location received. Ordnance is inbound. Out. Rounds complete. Out.
Bloody rain. Alright, someone has been shooting. Guess it's my AI. Again? Come on.
Crossroads to Nomad. Status report. Over.
I'm fine. Any more surprises?
We don't know. Midcom's got no idea what's causing it. According to seismic monitoring, this is abnormal activity.
What the hell are those guys shooting at?
Yeah. It carries on like this. We have no idea.
Hostile light armor. Nothing more than before.
200 meters. Front.
And don't
target
see
down.
Anything
target
incoming,
down.
Really.
Target neutralized.
Except the one my AI took out. Ah shit, I always hit escape. Nope, that's not what I wanted. I have my green team moving to the first building there. My red team has stopped engaging, apparently. They're hanging out with me here, that's alright. We're gonna move now too.
Team Green, move 100 meters, front.
On the way. Somebody help me.
Lopez, patch yourself up.
Understood. Standing by.
Cover me.
There's at least one guy remaining over there.
Rifleman, 200 meters, front.
At least. Come on, stabilize the camera, please. Alright, now we got some KIAs there. My AIs did a good job. There's still movement though. That IFV over there. Can't really tell you if it's down or not. Oh no, it's burning. Or it's a wreck, basically. So that's gone too now. Still don't see anything closing in. Should be my team here. So I got enemies coming towards
Man,
me apparently.
100 meters, right up ahead.
On the main road. And they're trying to flank me as well.
On the move.
Get the vehicle crew.
I'm covering. Go.
At least one of them.
Out of ammo. Understood.
This guy, oh, there he is. He knows exactly where I am.
Team Green, move 75 meters front.
Waiting.
Check the drone again. Maybe I can detect something inside the camp first. That should be me there. The left is my other team approaching. Those dead guys? Okay, there's at least one guy in the camp still alive. They seem to be dead, and the freaking camera is horrible.
Ready.
Okay.
5 meters. Good. Contact.
Head down.
Okay, just lost one of my teams there.
Return to formation.
I have to
crossroads. Captain is
secure. My squad.
I'll copy. Over.
Good work, Nomad. Stand by.
But yeah, it worked out in the end. Let's see if they need some.
Nomad, you've got enemy reinforcements approaching Kappa, inbound from the northeast. You need to halt their offensive. Artillery and CAS is on standby when you need it. Over.
Copy that, Crossroads. Out.
Artillery and CAS. Taking some cover. Oh, I miss my my real life teammates here compared to AI.
Waiting.
I got a runner there, but if that's actually my buddy.
Contact,
my AI
rifleman.
Guy. Fucked up camera. No, that's a hostile.
Man down.
Another friendly down. Dude, it's just out there. Still alive.
Fall back.
Understood.
Move up.
Wilco.
Team Red.
I hear a vehicle of some sort.
Move up.
On the way.
Let's see. Whoa, we get a lot of radar contacts here. Let's do some flying then. Yeah, okay. No, I really miss you guys. If you look at that shit here. Whoa.
Tank, 300 meters, northeast. Tank, 200 meters, front.
Is that a hit?
Waiting.
I think that was an IFV. Shit, named AT. One more radar contact. So still have artillery available too, so at least you got quite a bit of support. You've got so much that you do have some tactical decisions to make, or that you have have the ability to make some tactical decisions. So it's not like really predefined how you have to play the mission. You get some, there's some space for your own decisions. But you could either use the drone to designate and engage with laser guided artillery, for example, or you can just use it with the ATG missiles.
Hey, 600 meters, northeast.
I'm gonna release the controls, basically switch to turret controls. Maybe I have to give it a new waypoint again. Terminal. Oh, it still seems still to. Oh, that's good. Waypoint still set. There's a Strider. Question is how up to date this this map information is. Pretty sure there's still hostiles around. Yeah, there's infantry. Hostile infantry pushing my way. Thing is flying pretty low though. Might as well climb a bit. Oh yeah, I do have hostile infantry over there, so I'm gonna maybe call in some artillery if I still got. Of CAS helicopter, okay. I took out most of the vehicles.
Requesting close air support at the designated location.
I guess CAS helo could do a good job.
Roger. Coordinates received. CAS is inbound. Out.
Where's the rest of my buddies? Should be in that house. Way too much stuff going on in that scroll menu. It's oh man. It's no fun.
Requesting immediate fire support at the designated coordinates.
I mean, how are you supposed to designate the target with the laser marker on the UAV if you can't even properly track it? How are you supposed to hit something like that? It seems as if CAS is coming. I don't think those were the artillery rounds already.
Rounds complete. Out.
This would be ridiculous. And yeah, they really should add something like that. I mean, sure, when you let it go, it does somewhat stabilize, but it's impossible to kind of place it over the area where you want. Okay, that was kind of lucky now. Okay, now the vehicle is moving away, for sure. But it might get taken out by a CAS any second anyway.
Splash! Out!
Okay, I think one of those was pretty good. I'm not sure if that was actually one of those guided rounds. That might have been the second one, but if it's not solid on the target, it's not gonna work. I think CAS is engaging like crazy there. Or CAS might even be engaging my laser target. That's also possible. That thing is a machine gun though, so might take out my chopper. Yeah. Alright, that's that. Cast's gone. Just gonna call fucking AG on their asses.
Requesting immediate fire support at the designated coordinates. Over. Target location received. Coordinates is inbound. Out.
Area clear.
There's my helo. Okay, that was kind of bad now. Well, first of all, you should never call in artillery on a populated area, but since I haven't seen any civilians yet, I think the city is abandoned, so I don't really pay attention to that. And it's also kind of mean because I'm not sure if the pilots are actually still alive there, maybe. But they might have been shot out of the cockpit by that one strider that was remaining.
Splash out.
I don't see the fireworks. Last round was maybe not too bad. I think I had some infantry contacts there. Well, it was just on the road next to them, but they don't even flinch, so I think I'm gonna have to hunt them down, maybe. They're kinda hiding there in those It's impossible to see if a guy's alive or if he's dead. Okay, this guy's still alive. This guy over there is dead. Thermal view is good, but if you can't really ID who's alive and who's not, it's kind of bad. Okay, what was that over there? I don't have anything on the radar, so that might be just a graphical glitch of some wrecks. It seems to be like that. It looks as if I have to do it myself.
Roger.
Can't do much with the drone. My CAS helo is down, and artillery is not that effective in an area like that. But it's time for a safe. Guys coming or no? Is there only one of them alive?
Sit rep.
Running low on ammo. Grid 2-1-3-1-6-2. Man down.
Okay.
Form file.
It's just two of us then.
Move 100 meters front.
On the way.
hell am I? Okay, those are the tangos. And where am I? Somewhere over there. Oh, that's me. Okay. Through the building, you're saying, crossing the road to that single building, and there's two in the backyard. Let's do this.
Return to formation.
Copy.
I think there's another one behind that wrecked building on the left.
Rifleman, 75 meters, front.
Come on, dude. He's in the bear state. Even though there's enemies around. Oh man, I don't want to freaking control AI all the time.
Patterson, lock and load.
There's two bad dudes in the backyard over there. That's not what I intended to do. It's more like it.
Man, 75 meters left.
I think they're over there in the
Contact the soldier.
Exactly there. I got shot from over there too. It's got a ghost contact. The Raven would be nice now. There's a guy behind that wrecked building. I am inside that one, where my AI is just chilling out, walking around easily. Easy peasy. I had two contacts here, I just see the one now though. So he might be trying to outflank me or so. It's something there in the out in the field. Yeah, there he is. He's kind of out of the open, so I should be good to... I actually have to be careful when I leave the compound here. I'm pretty sure I don't have a shot. I don't have a shot over there. No, I don't. Let's go to the same way as... we came in.
Go, all cover. Man, 100 meters, front!
That's what I expected. I mean, all I see is frickin' bushes. that's where he was. I guess you got my body.
Sit rep.
I'd really be surprised if this guy was still alive. Alright. And that tree is at the worst place possible right now. So there's a guy behind it. Shit. Was that a wall bounce? Damn it! Was that a wall or a tree bounce, or did I just was just freaking fragmentation damage it took there? Well, that guy's still there. He's just waiting for me, bastard. But he's not where I thought he was, he's on the left, so I can flank him easily. He's like in the backyard behind this building here. And I thought he would be right here. Apparently the war's not over yet. Just reading the comments there. As a mission maker yourself, could you give Wynn a score at 1 of 100? Well, it's kind of hard to judge yet because it's like the fourth mission I play of Wynn. I just thought about it tonight. I like the entire campaign of ARMA 3. You know, the storyline is good.
We've beaten back the enemy offensive.
And the mission editing is done well. A lot of small details. You know, just like how the environment is polished with the tiniest objects. Sometimes. So that's the effort is. I would say, thumbs up for efforts. What I have issues, especially now with the Wing campaign, is that there's so much stuff going on. The mission creator, they put so much stuff in there with like kind of ambient stuff, you know, with a lot of vehicles driving around, a lot of explosions and all that, and a lot of AI, obviously. And that just, at least for me, even though I do have a pretty good PC, that drops the frame rate quite a bit. And that's something I didn't experience in a negative way in the previous two episodes, because those missions were a bit more low profile, they were a bit more stealthy maybe, and maybe not that much stuff going on, not that many enemies. And since now it's like coming towards the big end, they thought, okay, we gotta really make this action-packed, and this might now affect the frame rate for some people, because there's just so much stuff going on in the mission. The community made like a caching script already, a unit caching and redistributing system. Basically, you create anything you want in the editor, and then that script will pack everything, kind of hide it, and you can set a certain radius around the player in which the actual units in the editor will spawn. This will keep your frame rate. You can create missions with a million units if you want in the editor. It's not possible, but you could technically. The mission will run just smooth, because it will only display, actually virtually display, the stuff that is within a certain radius as the alive mod that you might know for ARMA 3. And that's something that's not happening in those missions, and because there's a lot of stuff going on, the frame rate is pretty low sometimes. That's definitely a negative point. I'm not gonna give it a ranking now. I mean, it's a good campaign. I do like it really. And also in win now, it seems as if the AI is not as strong as it used to be. Maybe BIS did some tweaking. Maybe the actual difficulty settings, the game options, do actually work, because for a long time that did not work. You could set the values to whatever the hell you wanted to. It would not work. It would not change something. And maybe that is actually working now, or maybe I'm just focused more on playing against the AI. Against like default AI, maybe a bit more careful. I cannot really tell you, but I don't struggle as much in win as I did in the previous episodes. For me, it's more enjoyable.
What the fuck? Where are you? Lieutenant James?
Nice animations going on here. Okay, Lieutenant James. Who's Lieutenant James? Find James. Have I met James before? Was that my platoon leader all the time? The name's not even familiar. Because I was talking, kind of missed what's about to happen. Regroup with NATO, find James. Well, that sounds simple enough, doesn't it? Where am I right now? Oh, I'm here. Regroup there. And move there. Alright, not before a short break though. Quick smoke, take a piss. And I'm right back in about 5 minutes.